Hello everyone, I'm Sarah Blotvy and this is part 3 of our Learning Campbell Biology classes, okay? So without any further ado, let's see what we are going to learn today, okay? Emergent properties. These are the main subjects that I will be talking about in this video, okay? What does emergent properties mean, and are emergent properties just for living things? What does systems biology even mean? Okay, so first up is what does emergent properties mean? So let's start from that one. Okay, to learn emergent properties, we will re-examine these two pictures, this one and this one, okay? And if you don't recall seeing these pictures, be sure to check my last video, okay? I will put a link in the description below, okay? This time, we are going to zoom out from the molecular level to the biosphere level, okay? Until here. So, some might ask, why are we even using this approach, okay? This approach allows us to see new properties emerge at each level that are absent in the last level, okay? Properties that are present in organelles but are not present in molecules, okay? These emergent properties are due to the arrangement and interactions of parts as complexity increases in For example, photosynthesis occurs in an intact chloroplast, okay? But it doesn't or it can't happen inside a disorganized test tube with the same molecules that are inside a chloroplast, okay? It doesn't work that way. So, the coordinated processes of photosynthesis require a specific organization of these molecules in the chloroplast, okay? In conclusion, isolated components of living systems, the objects of study in a reductionist approach, lack a number of significant properties that emerge at higher levels of organization. Okay, now we are going to talk about, are emergent properties unique for living things or to living things? Okay, let me tell you the exact answer. It's no. Emergent properties are not just for living things or life, okay? Take for example a box that has clock parts inside it. Okay, but these parts won't tell you the time. And now we are going to talk about what does systems biology mean. Okay, to fully explore emergent properties, biologists complement reductionism with systems biology. In more detail, systems biology means the exploration of biological systems by analyzing the interactions among its parts, okay? In this context, a single leaf cell, or a frog, or a desert ecosystem is a system. Now, by examining and modeling the dynamic behavior of an integrated network of components, systems biology enables us to pose new kinds of questions. Okay, some examples might be, how does the increase of in atmospheric carbon dioxide alter the ecosystems and the entire biosphere, okay, and other questions. So in conclusion, systems biology can be used to study life at all levels. Okay everyone, now we have reached the end of another video, and if you like this video, please like and share, and I'll see you in the next video.